November 28, 1960, two Italian ham radio operators were scanning the radio frequencies used by the Soviet Union satellites in the vastness of the night. Until at a certain moment, the silence was finally broken by a noise, some kind of code that repeated over and over again. The signal had a decreasing frequency and an increasing wavelength. Based on the Doppler effect, that meant that the object, whatever it was moving away from Earth. Intrigued, the operators analyzed the signal and managed to decipher its meaning. It was a message in Morse code which could be translated into just three letters, SOS. This is one of the many stories that fuel a fascinating mystery, a mystery that has been studied, researched, and surrounded by conspiracy theories. Has an astronaut ever gotten lost in space? The famous photo of American astronaut Bruce McCandless leaves us amazed, but also causes a certain amount of panic. Imagine being completely adrift, surrounded by darkness, seeing the Earth hundreds of kilometers away from your feet. In his case, it was a calculated move. Everything was in control. He returned safely to the spaceship and soon after to Earth. But has any human being ever been launched into the vastness of infinity and never returned? There are a lot of stories about supposed lost astronauts, or to be more precise, lost cosmonauts. The difference actually is just the place on the birth certificate. The word astronaut is usually used to refer to citizens of the United States and most other countries. A cosmonaut is a person born in Russia or the former Soviet Union. There are also taikonauts, who are Chinese individuals who travel to space. Regardless of the name, the fact remains that there are numerous spooky stories about people who supposedly died in some way in space and whose stories were covered up by the authorities, sparking speculation and intrigue. The majority of these cases would have occurred during the Cold War. In those times, the world was in a state of heightened alertness due to the tension between the United States and the Soviet Union, both on Earth and in space. The space race was starting to take shape, and the universe was becoming the new battleground in the confrontation between major global powers. Americans and Soviets competed to make the biggest advancements in exploring the universe. Despite the United States being the first to reach the moon in 1969, the Soviets were pioneers in numerous other achievements prior to that historic event. They sent the first object to enter orbit, the Sputnik 1. They sent the first man into space, Yuri Gagarin. They sent the first woman into space, Valentina Tereshkova, and they even sent the first dog into space. It was the dog Laika. But if on one hand the Soviets were pioneers in several cool things in space, they were also the first in major tragedies. The first death on a space mission was that of cosmonaut Vladimir Komarov on Soyuz 1 in 67. His capsule parachute didn't work during the takeoff from the atmosphere, and it crashed at full speed into the ground here on Earth. A few years later in 1971, another Soviet tragedy, and once again at the time of re-entering the atmosphere. The Soyuz 11 capsule experienced a decompression, and the three cosmonauts on board perished immediately. And because of this risk of failures, it was common for the rulers of the time not to inform in advance about the space missions. Many times they were only disclosed after the rocket had already left the atmosphere. If everything goes well, great. If something went wrong, authorities would conceal it and assign an alternate designation, avoiding the admission of a tragedy in the space program. And that's because one of the most important elements in the Cold War was propaganda. Any sign of defeat could be exposed by the other country and used to demoralize the opposing regime. And that is the reason why there were a bunch of suspicious cases that the Soviet authorities attempted to sweep under the rug. And the most serious of all, certainly, was the Nedelin catastrophe in 1960. That catastrophe was a huge explosion that happened while a missile was being prepared for launch. The USSR attempted to conceal the incident, and the precise death toll remains unknown, but it is believed to be between 60 and 150. And there are also other symbolic cases. The death of Yuri Gagarin himself, the first person to go to space, is still surrounded by mysteries. He died in 1968 in an airplane crash, the causes of which were never fully clarified. Another mysterious death of a Soviet in the 60s was Valentin Bondarenko, who died in a fire in a soundproof test chamber during endurance tests for space travel. The government prohibited news on the subject, and the tragedy's details were only revealed 25 years later. So all of this mystery surrounding the Soviet space program kind of fueled the emergence and development of conspiracy theories. Some of them, in fact, about the alleged lost cosmonauts. And it's these stories that we're going to investigate in this video. One of the most famous cases was that of Grigory Nelyubov. he was selected for the first Soviet class of cosmonauts. The group posed for a series of photos that were released by the government. This was one of the pictures taken at the time. What happened was, later on, another photo was also published. Observe that it is the identical picture, but one of the individuals was merely deleted from the original image. That guy was Grigory Nelyubov. The Soviet Union says he became an undisciplined soldier and that he liked to have a few too many drinks. So he would be a bad example to be followed, and therefore the Soviets chose to exclude his image from history as if he had never existed. This incredibly peculiar story was a delight for conspiracy theorists to speculate whether Grigory had not, in fact, been an astronaut who perished in outer space. The Soviet Union made sure to deny it and said that he was transferred to a remote base in Siberia and got run over by a train. Anyway, that was just one of several suspicious cases of lost cosmonauts. By the way, another well-known story involves not one, but four cosmonauts. The information was published in this American newspaper in 1959, that is, prior to Yuri Gagarin's first journey. And in the newspaper, it is reported that reliable sources in the former Czechoslovakia guaranteed that the Russians had made four unsuccessful attempts to send a person into space, and that one of these people, in fact, would be a woman. All those cosmonauts would have died. But a journalist specialized in space coverage found out that, in fact, it was a group of high-altitude skydivers who had never even been to space. A few more years? Another rumor of a missing cosmonaut. It all started when there were only a few days left until Yuri Gagarin's rocket launch. At the time, the Soviet Union announced that another high-ranking military officer, Vladimir Ilyushin, had been involved in a serious car accident. But a British tabloid published that this story would be fake, and that in fact, Vladimir would have been on a space trip that failed a few days earlier. The rumor gained new versions, including that his spaceship would have crashed in China and that the local authorities would have covered up the accident. Once again, space exploration experts scoured all available literature on the subject and assured that it was all just a rumor planted in the newspapers of the time. It's just that the narrative war between the United States and the Soviet Union led unverified history to newspapers, which often bought the government's version without properly investigating the information. Do you want one more example? Check out this news from 1962. The Soviets might have a dead body in orbit around the Earth. In the text, the spokesperson for the US Air Defense says Soviets put first cosmic coffin in celestial cemetery. Which is kind of poetic, but also total nonsense. According to Yuri Gagarin's biography, the most probable is that the cosmonaut was a dummy. Ivan Ivanovich, who was actually a dummy used by the Soviets in space tests. It traveled with a recording with a human voice to test if the radio was working. And this story, by the way, reminds me of one of the most epic pranks ever pulled by the Soviets. In 1968, when there was still a year left for a human being to step on the moon, the Soviet Union launched the first spacecraft that made a complete orbit around the moon. It was the Zond 5, which was an unmanned spacecraft, except for some plants and a few fly eggs. But anyway, there were no humans. But the cosmonauts here on Earth, apparently with a lot of free time, decided to play a prank on the Americans. They knew that the United States was always intercepting radio signals, so they left a pre-recorded audio playing during the mission. And the recording said, "The flight is proceeding as normal. We're getting closer to the surface of the moon." The teasing left the Americans in a panic because they thought the Soviets were going to the moon before them. Another story of a lost cosmonaut also surfaced via a prank. It was a legend fabricated by the Spanish conceptual artist Juan Fontecuberta. He conducted a presentation in multiple countries regarding a purportedly missing astronaut named Ivan Sternikov. And it was all a joke. Sternikov actually means covered fountain, just like his family name suggests. And the astronauts' photos were a montage with the artist's own face. However, many news sources reported the case as if it were true, giving rise to yet another rumor in circulation. But of all the stories of lost cosmonauts, I kept the most famous one for last. Now I'll explain who the two Italian radio amateurs were that intercepted a mysterious signal from space. They were the brothers Giovanni and Aquile Giudica Cordiglia. They were young people fascinated by radio technology. The device was built by them on their own terrace to capture radio waves. Their story is told in the documentary Space Hackers. In the movie, they say it started as a hobby until the day that forever changed their lives, the launch of Sputnik 1. The brothers discovered the correct frequency and captured this audio recording. From that point forward, they began monitoring Soviet space activity from within their own residence. When it came time for Sputnik 2, they recorded what, according to them, would be the heartbeat of the little dog Laika. However, it was a few years later, in 1960, that they received the initial signal, supposedly from a lost cosmonaut. That was the Morse code distress signal I showed at the beginning of the video. And after that, the brothers state that they recorded even more potential evidence of secret cosmonauts. In 1961, for example, the ham radio operators detected a fast heartbeat, this time from a human being, accompanied by the heavy breathing of someone in space. Coincidence or not, 2 days after the broadcast, the Soviet authorities admitted that they had put a 12-meter, 7-ton spacecraft into orbit, supposedly unmanned, but it ended up catching fire. Very suspicious, Soviet Union. So the brothers decided to upgrade the equipment to get higher quality recordings. They started operating in Tore Bird, a deactivated bunker from World War II. So they captured the most shocking recording of all. A female voice that would be from a cosmonaut screaming desperately for help. And because it's the most shocking recording, it also raised the highest number of suspicions. The Italian brothers were accused of having forged the audio. There has never been a formal investigation of the case, but a few things have raised doubts about the recording. The first thing is that no other authority from any other country was able to intercept this transmission. I mean, with all the fancy intelligence service gadgets during the Cold War, only two Italian young ham radio operators were going to make this discovery. Moreover, the communication by the supposed cosmonaut lacked official protocol. She omits self-introduction and avoids technical jargon in the broadcast. Okay. But if I were in a spaceship on fire, plummeting towards Earth, I probably would skip protocol and fancy jargon too. However, there are still more signs of fraud. Spaceships cannot communicate during re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. Pressing the capsule against the atmosphere creates an ionized air layer, disrupting radio signals and causing a communication blackout. This is why the return of astronauts to Earth is always surrounded by moments of silence and tension. The brothers may even claim that the recording was made a little before this phase. But still, there are other questions. One is about the capsule. Where would she have fallen? And the other is about the cosmonaut's voice. The Russian she speaks has an accent that is not from someone born in Russia. And this makes everything even more suspicious because, attention for the plot twist, the radio amateur brothers have a sister who is able to speak Russian. She claims that she learned the language specifically to aid her brothers with translations. However, with so many questions surrounding this, it is highly suspicious. That's why some people believe that she herself could have played the role of the cosmonaut in peril. The big problem is that all these doubts end up undermining the veracity not only of this case of the lost cosmonaut, but of all the material produced by the Italian radio amateurs. Although what they have is a very interesting file for analysis and debate, we ultimately can't prove the veracity of these recordings. The conclusion we can come to is that unless there has been some case so well covered up and therefore never discovered, the most likely thing is that all the stories of lost cosmonauts we have ever heard are false. Most probably, all of them are conspiracy theories, the outcome of a misunderstanding or someone's extremely creative imagination. And I hope I have clarified the lost astronaut story for you guys. Thank you very much and see you next time.